Hey guys, today I have a little 6-pin cylinder. It's a mailbox lock from China, and I got it from Wune International. We have a key, the bedding is pretty flat, but something to point with. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6-pinner. Should be able to rake it though, but we are going to single pin pick it. And if I remember correctly, this is, yes, it is a Ruco Keyway. It is a knockoff of a Ruco with 6 pins, but the keyway is more like what is on the 5-pinners, so they messed up a little bit there. Alright. Where is the tensioner? It was right there. And then we just need a pick. Where do we have it? There. Alright, let's see. Shouldn't be that hard. Oh, a little turn there. And we are open. So, pretty easy. Alright. I think you can already guess it is just a 5-pinner. Oh, sorry, a 6-pinner with standard pins, but we can still got it. I think we need that one. That one. And some tweezers. A pick. That limits how far it can turn. And the shim. That shouldn't actually be necessary with the shim though. Ah, that is just a little bit too big. But at least all 6 pins are there. Come on. The key was a little bit stuck. Alright, so not anything too high up, so the pins are not too long. But not too short either. All standard, just as I thought it would be. Standard in 1, standard in 2, standard in 3. I don't think I'm going to show these guys because all of it is just standard, so I'm not going to make a close-up on them, but yeah, we all know how a standard pin looks like. So standard all of it, and only one spring is longer than the others. And that is spring number 1. Now, why is that? I think it's because the hole is not drilled as far down as on the others. I don't know. All the springs are just the same as well. So all key pins and all driver pins and all springs is just standard. There's nothing special about it. But again, it's a Chinese lock. But at least it's a six pinner though. Alright guys, thanks for watching and have a good day.